Yo, what's up? My name is Jordan Mitchell, and in this video, I want to show you how to make this cool head bobbing effect for dance videos. It's kind of tedious, but it's pretty simple, and I haven't seen a video on it, so I just want to make something really quick, just because I want to get this out fast, and I think it should be pretty easy. And so I'm just going to show my editing breakdown of how I made this video from start to end. Here are the timestamps for the various sections that you can skip to. So this is a video I made for my friend Marvel. I started off with color correction, just because this video is shot so dark. In the effect that I'm going to do in a bit, to actually track the head bobbing, you need contrast. For me, I was tracking his head, so I needed to have some point on his head that had visible contrast, which ended up being his hat and his face. It's so dark, you can't really see much, but I just wanted to lift up a little bit. I can make a full tutorial on how I color correct. Anyways, all right, then I want to open this in After Effects. So open After Effects and create a new project, then go back to Premiere and right click on the video file that you want to place and press replace with After Effects composition, which should open it up in After Effects now. Then what you want to do is go up to Window and make sure that tracker is selected. That should bring it up somewhere on your screen on the right side here. Then I scrub forward to where I want the camera tracking to begin and press stabilize motion. That'll bring up this tracking point. And essentially, like I said, you want to find a place that has high contrast where a light section is meeting a dark section. So this can be anything from an eye. You can track on like the corner of an eyebrow or like a button on somebody's shirt. For me, I wanted to track his face, and obviously you can't see his face, so I kind of did the corner of his hat and his hair. You want to make sure that plus lines up there. And then that's pretty much it. You just need to do this frame by frame. So again, it's very easy process. It's just very tedious. See, there's two options here. There's the play triangle, and then there's the next frame triangle. You can do play, and that'll essentially play through the video and auto track it. If your video is as low quality as this, I wouldn't recommend that. And even if you have a high quality video, you'll probably end up having to press play and stopping a lot. But especially because this was such a low quality video, I just went individual frame by frame and pressed analyze next frame, and then just adjusted to make sure that this little plus icon lined up with where I was trying to track, which was the right side of where his hat meets his hair. Then you literally just go frame by frame. One thing that you'll notice with him, he did a couple of spins, which obviously makes it difficult because you can't see the front where his hair is. So essentially what I tried to do here is right above his left eyebrow where the hat hole meets his hair. I tried to imagine I could see through the back of his head where this point was on his head. Ideally, you can track things that stay in frame for the whole time. Same thing here. His hand is covering it, so you kind of just have to imagine where that point would be roughly if you could see through his hand. Then again, you just go frame by frame. So then once you do that, I wanted to make sure that what I was doing was actually working. You can press apply and then make sure that X and Y is selected up here. Then just press OK. If you go on the same old layer and press stabilize motion again, like if you've already applied the effect and then you want to stabilize it again, like for the second half of the video, it'll end up deleting your initial keyframes, if that makes sense. You need to make a new layer. If you press U on your keyboard, you can see all the keyframes, which are these little diamonds. Go to where the last keyframe is and make sure the playhead is there, and then press Control Shift D or Command Shift D if you're on Mac, and that'll cut the clip in half and create a new layer. Then on this new layer, you can go press stabilize motion again and can continue tracking. If that doesn't make sense, like leave a comment and I'll try to explain it better. Basically, just do that. Also, if you notice at some point, it'll get pretty hard to track if your thing is actually at the right point. See, with all these old keyframes here, which is why a couple of times in the middle, I ended up pressing apply and just creating new layers. But once I finished all of this, you can see that the effect happens pretty well. It tracks his head motion and it looks pretty cool. However, one thing you'll notice, especially on these big jumps down, because it's such a drastic change in eye level, there's these black bars at the bottom. This is something I think that is actually interesting. It's kind of like a common Photoshop technique, but I haven't really seen people do it in video. What I did is went back to Premiere, held Alt, and dragged this video layer up one track. So essentially that makes a duplicate. So now there's two identical video files on top of each other. What you're going to do with the bottom one is go to Effects and press Vertical Flip, drag it on. Essentially what this will do is take your video, turn it upside down. So now if you drag that video now to the bottom, it will line up. So yeah, like if you go frame by frame, it'll look weird because you can see his leg flipped at the bottom, but it looks better than a black bar. And you can't really notice it. It looks kind of like a cool trippy effect anyways. You don't want to change the X positioning just because it's already lined up. The X is like left and right. Then the Y axis, which is up and down, you want to drag the bottom layer down so that it lines up perfectly with the top video. If you can see here, it looks pretty seamless. And what you want to do is press this little stopwatch to create a keyframe, and then just go forward frame by frame and adjust the Y positioning of that bottom video to make sure that it aligns and matches up well. And for this, you can't really take shorter steps. It has to be every frame. So what that means is you can't just make one keyframe at the beginning, one keyframe at the top, and assume that it'll match up, which is what I tried to do initially, if you see here. But in the middle between those points, there's these black bars, which is why you need to go frame by frame, keyframing that position. Hopefully that makes sense. So because the coloring on this was so bad, I decided to actually make it look like a film overlay. Here, I'll leave the link to something in the description of where you can download an overlay like this. But for this, it's super easy. All you have to do is just drag it on top and then change the blending mode here to overlay. I put this over the video just because like it kind of makes the bad lighting seem intentional almost because it matches that film look. There were a couple of black bars to the side as well, and I didn't want to go through this whole keyframing thing that I just described with the vertical bars. So I just put on this film overlay to kind of cover the sides, which saved a bit of time for me. And it ended up looking pretty good. Like I said, it's a pretty easy process. It's just kind of tedious and takes some time to figure out. But let me know if this works. If anybody makes it, send me something on Instagram, jmish.co. It'd be dope if you actually ended up using this. But yeah, thanks for watching if you got to this point, and hopefully I help. All right, peace.